can't stop me from rapping, Kenny. Kenny Hop. I spit it through the wire, man. Too much stuff on my heart right now, man. I gladly risk it all right now. It's a life or death situation, man. Y'all really understand how I feel right now, man. It's your boy Kanye Titter. Shatown, what's going on?
So the purpose of our podcast slash mukbang is really to just shed light on the real things that go on in Chicago. And y'all getting it from Chicagoans slash suburbanites. Because some of us are from the south suburbs of Chicago. But yes! They is from Chicago, yes. Chicago. I was born in the suburbs of Chicago, but I'm a city girl. City girls make a wish like Ray J. Let me talk to you. And I know all the tea.
You know, all the back roads everywhere.
That she does.
You ever come to Chicago, you need to know where to go.
But I'm a suburban girl, too.
She's still very much so suburban.
Very much so.
She's a...
We're from all over, really. Yeah. Like, we all grew up in, like, a burb of some sort.
Of some sort.
We met in Chet Ben. I think that's when our life started.
Yes.
That's when my life began.
What year? Like, 07 and 08. They met in 07. I met them in 08.
Yes.
We joined a dance team called House Arrest 2 Championship Dancing.
Cheerio!
Don't play with it.
Dream team.
Okay. And, like, we've just been connected ever since.
Literally.
So, yeah.
And we're just sisters.
Yeah. So, we just be having a lot to say. And we want to, like, share light on Chicago. So, we just decided to do this.
Yes.
Give back to our people.
Yes. Yeah.
And also, we are... dressed so eloquently, mm-hmm. so beautifully.
Black
History Month. Because we celebrate Black History Month. We celebrate it every day. But, you know, we wanted to give y'all the full experience. First episode, first experience.
Yes.
Agreed.
Yes.
So thank y'all for tuning in.
Thank you.
We appreciate y'all so much.
Yes.
We will be able to drop all of our social media content either somewhere in this video or it'll be below, down in the comments, either or. So I feel like we should go ahead and get started with the purpose of the video.
Yes. This is her restaurant she chose.
Yes. Okay. This one was mine. I'm excited too. Okay. So first thing first, you guys, we are having Egusi soup and Fufu. Yes. Okay.
I'm a first timer.
We are. Yes. She is a first timer.
A while ago. So we'll just call this my first time.
Okay.
Born again.
Okay. And I'm knee deep
in all of it. Okay. She want us to switch over so bad.
So bad. I'm going to convert them, y'all, real soon. Give me a minute.
Veganism. I'll eat this.
So.
Not me. I need chicken.
Sundae is having. Is that what you're having? Chicken Egusi?
I am having chicken Egusi with. No, I'm having regular Egusi.
Okay.
No meat in it. No.
Okay.
But I have a chicken Jollof rice. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
I have a spicy Jollof.
You do not have spicy.
Oh, it's not spicy.
You were a child. You didn't want spicy food.
No, yeah. Because I wanted spicy rice.
Oh, you said it clear. You said if. So you can share. You can have my word.
Okay.
You can mix it in. She put that red sauce in avocado.
We can
you
share.
Yeah.
No she spice on the Egusi. So I guess I mean plain Jollof rice. With vegan Egusi and my fufu. Bella, how was yours prepared?
Oh,
I have regular
none of
Egusi
our Egusi got no meat.
And beef jollof. Yeah, the Egusi is just red sauce in here.
Okay.
To make it spicy and
I'm really excited. I'm a little nervous about the texture in my mouth, but I think I can get used to it.
I'm not. I like all textures.
In her mouth.
In and around my mouth.
All around my mouth. No.
Look at the juice.
It's just juicy, it's y'all. Just
juicy. That looks beautiful.
That's mm-hmm. what he said. Yeah.
That's what he said.
Okay. Well,
Lord, thank you for this food that we're about to receive and eat. Thank you for the hands to prepare the food. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all, here we go.
So you take pinches and you grab it, grab a little bit of everything, and then
this is so good. How spicy are y'all? Is y'all Egusi?
It's not bad.
It's not like crying, no. Hurt, scream for
it's
help.
It's spicy.
It's spicy.
Well,
right?
I got most mm-hmm. of it over here.
Y'all, it's I don't know. Good.
I'm very surprised that my taste buds is allowing me to eat this stuff.
You liking it?
It's a little funky, but I like
what
it.
What do you mean?
Like funky, like grapefruit. Mm-hmm. Not funky, like smell. You know, y'all know I use words to describe my food, so.
So the different and the
texture.
Okay.
The texture of the fufu. Mm. Like I literally can just swallow it.
Mm.
Yeah. I'm trying to chew it so I can get like a really good taste of it.
It's seasoned so well.
Mm-hmm. These greens bussing. Mm.
Like, mind you,
spinach.
Oh my God. Well, spinach, yes, because we did ask for spinach. But I feel like this greens too. I'm pretty sure it's greens.
Yeah, it's probably mixed some different type of greens.
Yeah, all right.
I have been eating Egusi soup and fufu for years, and this is hands down the best. Once I found Sesi, I never went anywhere else. Never went anywhere else.
Shout out to you, Sesi. She was such a pleasant woman to meet.
Big shout out.
She was beautiful.
Very, like, attentive when she came. When she heard us coming in the door, she came from the back, greeted us.
Is a very sweet
and woman. Then went back to doing what she was doing. She also has like a little mini grocery part in her store where you can get a lot spices. Of spices and Jamaican
anything
ingredients
you cook with.
Like especially like if you want to make your own fufu,
Caribbean or
everything is in that store for that.
Can we get into this bread?
Oh, you're eating it.
Oh, it's delicious.
Now she, oh my gosh, she just gave us
she
like a
tried to take the bread out of the pitcher so many times.
I love bread. This is actually the first time I'm eating bread.
This
in a while.
Is so good. It's like it reminds me of a, y'all know that bread that y'all get from Outback, that brown bread?
Mm-hmm.
From Outback Steakhouse, pumpernickel bread, but the flavor is different.
They have spice. It's spicy.
Yeah, and then a little sweet, like a cranberry
this
or something.
This motherfucking
shit is hot. Yeah. Last time, you guys, I went, I said, Sesi, I want to try your spicy. I'm like, I always get regular. Let me try spicy. She was like, oh, you want spicy? I was like, yeah. She was like, okay. I should have knew then. I literally got home.
That's probably she gave you so much, though.
Trying to challenge me or something.
Yeah. I think she felt like. You
want to
be a big girl, huh?
I literally got home, took a bite, closed it up. I did not eat it. I literally ended up giving it to my person because he enjoys spicy food. Like, the man will eat a ghost pepper
and be okay.
As a snack.
I do, too. I love spicy food. Every time I eat, like, any fish or meat, I need, like, jerk sauce on it.
I enjoy spicy food.
I don't even go to hot sauce anymore. I just eat jerk sauce.
But over spice. Like, I want to taste the food. It can't be so spicy.
I can't
taste
the
food.
That's me.
I think this is a good medium, though.
Yeah, her spice is really good. It's spicy, though. I'm not a spicy girl.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a hot girl.
Like, I like hot food. We a hot girl.
But I can handle spice to a certain extent. Right now? It's kicking my ass.
Really?
It's pretty spicy.
Wow, she done put my... She ain't do me right now. Okay. Maybe hard. I need to mix it some. I'm not gonna get in there. I love eating with my hands.
Yeah, I enjoy eating with my hands.
I love, like, sloppy food.
My grandmother used to feed me with her hands. And I'm talking about regular food. Like, when she would sit and feed us, it would be with her hands. And it just would taste so good. It almost would taste 10 times
better. My little Mowgli.
It's some, I tell my sister, though, she be cooking. And my older sister, she be cooking, like, all the family meals. And certain dishes where she got to use her hands, she really uses her hands. And I be up in the kitchen looking like, gross. Like,
no!
Why you got to stick them little stubby things in the food like that? She's like, why? You got to mix it real good and show love to it.
People know what she's doing.
And once the food is done, I be like, there's something in them little fingers that she... The way she molds the food together. Something with the fingers, you know.
It's a black thing. It's a black thing.
I definitely think it's a black thing.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
For sure.
Yeah.
Passed down from generation to generation.
Oh, yeah. I can't stand when I'm out somewhere and I tell somebody I'm from Chicago, oh, you from Chi-Rack?
We do not call it that, y'all.
We don't claim that type of energy. Now, granted, Chicago has gotten ridiculous for the past couple. I mean, I kind of honestly feel like since I've been an adult, the transition from like...
At least the last 10 years.
Yeah. At least the last 10 years where I feel like Chicago has gotten reckless with the gun usage. But I also feel as though everywhere has their crime. You know, so there is no like, oh, I'm running away and I'm going to go here. Okay, you going to Wyoming and they got serial killers that hunt you down and slit your throat, drag you into the woods and have, like, that's their thing, you know? So it has nothing to do with location for me. It just has to do with saving the city. And that's wherever you go. Right now, guns is Chicago things. Definitely put the guns down. The change that I can say that I remember from me, what do we call the, what generation is we?
Millennials.
So the millennials versus way back when our parents were younger and we were babies, or even probably before we were born, there was structure and rules to gangs. Like it was, there were rules literally that you had to follow and they did. It was a no shoot, no kill rule when anyone was with their family. When they were with their wife or their children, you had to wait until you saw them again.
Scarface told y'all that.
Baby.
There's no code.
There's no code anymore. There was nothing. You weren't allowed to shoot up schools. You weren't allowed
scary,
to shoot up
cowardly
parks.
People.
Yes, and children.
Sick of them. And y'all need to get y'all kids.
Children. Y'all need to get y'all kids. That's
especially with Chicago. I don't know what's wrong with y'all mamas and daddies. Y'all let y'all kids run crazy. Through the city doing crazy, like I don't understand. I don't understand.
They're
when these young kids
too,
get
you know?
Caught and we see them on the news and stuff, and we be like, they was only 14, 15, what?
13.
Where's your mom? Like, I get y'all working, y'all gotta provide. I get it. Trust me, I'm a single mom of two living in Chicago, so I get it. But ain't no way in hell I'm finna have my 13, 14 year old girl ripping and running the street, nor my son ripping and running the street. I don't know what they're doing. I'm that parent that's all up in your business.
Oh, I was gonna say, because kids are clever. You know, kids are clever. And
they are.
And they'll figure it out.
And we've been there, we've done that. Like, but we weren't out in the streets like that. Like, we was outside, but we was outside playing. And getting mad because we had to come in before the streetlights came on.
It was just more like we cared about ourselves. We care about our friends more. I think now everything is so...
Self.
Like, no one really know themselves. So they looking for some guidance on this little thing, you know. no one to instill real value. So when they do go outside, they think it's a game. Like, I honestly think these kids think, like, life is a game. You get shot, you, like, get to XP.
Yeah, they be playing that damn Grand Theft Auto crap. Right, that's Grand another thing. No, no. I even get mad when they just playing, and I'm like, why are you just beating the woman up? Like, what is the purpose of this damn game?
If the purpose is to train our children to grow up thinking that this is what desensitized them, and this is what a relationship should have, in this is what a Black relationship, an indigenous, pardon my French, an indigenous native relationship should look like. That's the sad part. These games, these 007s and all of those, whatever the freak shoot 'em up, bang bang games, those should not be allowed to be played in your household as a parent. I'm not telling nobody how to teach, but I'm telling you guys what we're raising by allowing these things. Now, I will say, gun usage should be shown to your children at a certain age. Mm-hmm. They should be kids and they should know about guns, but they should learn it from you directly.
Yep.
And they should learn that it's not a toy. They should learn to not allow it to train their brain to think that it's normal, because that's what the game is doing. Go out, shoot them up, slap this hoe, throw her in the trunk. No, we're showing them strategic information about how to properly use a gun, when to use a gun. You know, like, they should survival know those things. Instance. Survival tactics.
Instance,
it's not a game. Even toy water guns. I can't get with it. Because when you really think about it, what about a gun is a toy? What about a gun is a toy? Nothing. Yeah. So why are we training them that this water gun, because it shoots water. But children's brains don't think like that. Y'all know how many kids killed either themselves, their sibling, or their parents because they picked up a real gun and went boom? Because that's what they're used to doing with the... I mean, yeah, that lacks on our point as a parent as well, because we shouldn't have them around for them to pick up like that and have access to. But we still also...
Because I love guns. Like, I love water guns. I love Nerf guns. And then, like, for boys... That's like a good toy for them. For me, you just got to educate your kids on guns and the safety of them and what's real and what's fake. You know, some people don't do that. And I think that's where a lot of confusion come in at. Yeah, because you can't really keep kids from play guns. I mean, you could, but they're going to eventually find it. Somebody's going to buy them a play gun unless you like specifically like, nobody my kid no play gun.
They're gonna get exposed.
I'm gonna be that mama.
The biggest thing.
Don't buy my kid no play
to teach them properly, you know.
Because there ain't nothing playful about a gun. When my kid got a gun, we at the range.
Like, I'm trying to get my kids into like.
But no, that's what I'm saying. If you can't shelter them from guns.
Yeah, you can't.
You have to educate. So if you're not gonna educate,
stay away from.
Regulate. You can't stay away. They're gonna. Okay, that's what I'm saying. Like, you're either gonna teach them about this fully. Or
allow them to gain.
You're gonna allow them to gain their own knowledge of it and
use it how they see fit.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But so. With the world we live in, the internet has no filter. Like, they're gonna see it. So I would rather my child see it and know something about it, or know like, oh, my mom talked to me about this. They'd rather be like, never see it and be the one that's like playing with it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But education and regulation.
Education and regulation. I love it.
Baby.
Okay, y'all. So listen, this was delightful.
It was awesome.
Hands down, it was really bomb. I think we should take this moment.
Sesi, thank you. Thank you so much.
Sesi, thank you so much for being
very, very good. Okay. It was really good.
Yeah, we'll definitely be tagging her info. Chicagoans or visitors, if you're here, when you're here, suburban restaurant, we will be tagging all of her info so you guys can tune
in
to her.
Description below.
Ooh, I'm stuffed. I think I'm done.
I've been done.
She been done.
I've been done.
It's so good.
Mm-hmm. Chicago, outside of that aspect of Chicago, to me, Chicago is a very, very great city. It's very family oriented. You can come here with your family on vacation and have a great time. Chicago summers.
Unmatched.
Unmatched. Baby. For real.
I don't care where you at.
Baby. Right. Like,
I've been to all the popular states during the summer.
And Chicago is unmatched.
For and sure. Guess what?
Period.
Along with the entertainment that you get, the it's people. The food for me.
It's the food, food and the people. And the
people.
Okay.
Scenery.
That's true.
Everybody needs them a Chicagoan.
That's true.
In their life.
Yeah, we are very kind people.
I guess because we're in the Midwest and yeah. How we everything else is like around us. Mm-hmm. I guess like we kind of get it when we go mm-hmm. to other people's states. Yeah, just know that Chicago people is we're that we're
come
the
in
people.
The summer. And then we've had more vitamin D, so we're happier. You come in the winter, we like
well, cranky.
Slacking. We gotta get it other ways and shit.
Not so proud.
My birthday is in the winter and I'm legit trying to celebrate it.
Okay. But they have some really fun drinks. So the first one, we have pineapple. Yeah. We have a ginger drink.
No, that is no, a grapefruit.
That's grapefruit. That's
it's called Ting.
Oh, grapefruit.
Kind of like squirt.
Squirt, yeah, but better.
Okay. And then we have a pineapple ginger, my fave. And then we have a sorrel ginger. Okay.
Let's try the juices first.
Yes. Let's try the juices first.
Okay.
Shake them up. For your own poison.
I'm supposed to just be tasting it.
I'm gonna get a whole cup.
Cheers, cheers to sorrel. Hoot hoot.
Baby, that ginger don't play.
Oh my god.
Bitch,
I cannot stand stuff that takes me by surprise.
You know what it tastes like when your freeze pop?
Girl, no, it doesn't. It tastes out. Like ginger. It just does tastes like bad. Ginger.
I don't taste the ginger. It's not enough.
You wouldn't. But it's a, you probably didn't.
She eats it daily, yeah. So it's different for her. But me, I'm just trying to get into this stuff. This ginger is like the spice, almost.
It hit you in the back of the throat.
I like it.
I bet you do. So that's yours.
Oh, yeah. I like it a lot.
Yeah, you can have that.
We're going to let you have that one.
That's good.
Man, I got to drink the rest of this. Cause
it definitely gives me... it definitely gives me that melted freeze pop.
The 50 Cent ones, like, yes. You let them melt for a while, the juice, like...
It does give that energy with some ginger added.
Yeah.
I like it. What's next?
Since we already know what she giving, I don't really want to try the pineapple.
I want to try the pineapple because I love pineapple.
I love pineapple ginger.
I'm going to let y'all go for that. I'll pour you that. Pour you that.
You good on the pineapple ginger?
I just think that I don't like the sorbet.
Because I really wanted this one and I don't want it to like...
Throw off your palate.
Yeah. So let me get y'all together. Y'all know I'm fancy because I put my pinky up.
Okay. I think I can smell.
It's gonna go pass out.
Oh my
it's a no.
God! Hell no!
Let me taste.
She's gonna like it.
Yeah, she's gonna like it. Oh, this is decent.
This is good. Mmm. Let me go get
them. Y'all, I think we have pretty worldly palates, Sundae and I, but. Nina
really
comes
good.
From the stratosphere with some of these textures and foods and stuff. But I'm excited.
That's so good.
Be on her side about something. But something. I'm not on her side.
I love when these two be like, yes, Nene, that's good. It makes me feel so
yeah,
good.
Yeah, because we're all her side. Sometimes we gotta like.
That they do.
So yeah, when we give you the thumbs up, you know it's real.
I know it's real. Okay, all what's right. Next?
We're trying pineapple soft drink.
Hurry up and give me some of that. I know I'm gonna like this.
You drink pop, Nina?
Nope.
I didn't
today.
But I'm tasting it today.
A bit of
it's soap. Not a pop, it's a soft drink. Here, here.
I like it. I feel like I could name everything that's in this. That's a good pineapple. You don't like it? Mm-mm. It's fire.
Fire. It's a no
I
for
need
me.
Some crunchy curls.
Period. The old flavor.
Right.
Not this
the original.
I don't know what they're doing now.
No, what the fuck they tastes like seasoning.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's not good.
Ugh. That's way better for me.
Yeah, I agree.
If I have to drink it, that'd be my drink.
I'm good on the Sof drink.
And this Sof. I couldn't shake this, right? No.
Spookling.
I just
want to
make sure.
Love it.
Yes, this is you put your pinky out and you drink with the sparkling. Let's taste.
This tastes, yeah. This is Ting.
Baby, this is a hit for me. This is the one.
Oh, yeah. Y'all on the phone.
That's good.
That's the one for me. I'm happy now. Them first two, blue. Blew my taste buds.
Yeah. I'm glad we did this last.
Yeah. Way better.
This is like, you have to eat slow. You got to put like
that shit right here. It's hitting, though. It's hitting, though.
I'm going to have a bubble of tequila in it, baby.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Which one is that one, you guys? The sparkling grapefruit?
Yes.
Yes, it's called Ting. Some teen. This is definitely giving it's a teen. Some teen.
Very yeah, this much is the winner. Teen. All three of us are very happy with this.
Yeah, one. That one's yeah. The one. Mm-hmm.
I bet you're not going to be against this ice.
Mm. I'm trying to stay away. That is good. That was delicious. Really good. It's like a, it reminds me of like a ginger ale, but with so much more flavor.
Ooh, yeah. Citrus, like.
Yeah,
I like grapefruit tastings and some drinks.
That was better than squirt.
If like you can squirt, make a really good grapefruit,
that's better than squirt. Just let me hit that one more time.
Here it is.
You don't even drink pop.
It's a sparkling.
Thing. I'm sorry.
Thank you. Thank
that's
you
why
someday.
I didn't feel bad about drinking it because it's sparkling something. It's not just soda. Mm-hmm.
Okay, you guys, we are overly stuffed, so let's move this party to the sofa. Come on.
Welcome, bitch. Yeah. Welcome, welcome. Yeah. She has to get undressed. I dang near took a little nap on the chase.
Me too.
I don't know how Sundae over there making it, but she's still wrapped up in the motherland.
That's like a.
This like a
duster.
Yeah. It's like a duster, like your grandparents. This is what my grandparents and aunties and shit wore around the house cleaning up. Making chicken and pork chops and stuff.
And feeding us with their hands.
Yeah. Taking that's exactly what they were.
Thank y'all for sharing that meal with us.
It was so delightful. We hope that you guys enjoyed it. And y'all go try the Fufu.
Go see Sesi.
Yes. Try
go
it out.
Go see Sesi. 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 Go see Sesi.
If y'all ever see Stepbrothers, that's how I feel like when I read the news, like Stepbrothers. Like, if y'all ever seen that movie.
Never
like,
fails. Stepbrothers or, not the Wedding Crashes. What was the other one? The Breakup. Please don't touch my ruffles.
And on the kick drum.
And Aaron. In the house. Drum. Come on the kick drum. Aaron. Come.
Yo. That was the funniest.
Memories.
Vince Vaughn.
Oh, hands down. Genius. Yes, he is. Love him.
So we're doing our wind down, y'all. We just gonna kick it with y'all.
And jump into these topics.
Jump into these hot tops.
Flaming hot. Oh, I feel like the first topic should be about the juice and the tea that you have, Bella.
Okay.
I think that's some great tea to open up this space with.
Maybe that's fertilizer for the world, baby. Mm-hmm. World, stop. Okay, wake up. Okay, in case you don't know, in case you've lived under a rock, even if you live under rocks, I feel like you know what I'm about to, you know, shed light on. The queen herself has started. She started her tour. Beyonce is going on tour, and what I believe is this will be like act two. I think it'll be act two. But Lil Wayne too is coming to Chicago. He's going on tour. Y'all. These ticket prices? Let me.
A boot. Higher than giraffe coochie.
A boot. She fooled us. We was ready.
You know what? I wouldn't even say I was fooled. Because we did this with formation. We knew. But I feel like
but bitch, formation wasn't $1,000 for a decent seat.
It wasn't.
Hell, I didn't pay $1,000 to go to formation, baby.
And I got two tickets, and I don't even think. It didn't touch
1,000,
and we had some good ass seats.
Right, it didn't touch I don't think it touched damn near $500 for two seats. I mean, two tickets. So yeah, we kind of think that our good sis, B, she kind of tripping with this $1,000.
It's not just her, because Wayne is coming to Chicago, so he's going on tour as well. The Carter 2 tour, and the venue that he's going to, and at least the one here in Chicago, is really small, standing room only. Smallest ticket is $350 to stand stage level. So that means if it's somebody 6 feet in front of you, you're not seeing much. $350 to go see Lil Wayne. So,
I mean, I feel like Lil Wayne is still doable. Like, granted, you That's said the space it. Is small, but it's still $350 for a ticket to see Wayne, and it's Wayne. It's Wayne.
And I ain't seen him yet.
Yeah. So I feel like Beyonce. That's doable. I feel like her.
So it's like Beyonce gonna get chopped.
The lesser evil, right. I think I'm gonna wait on the Netflix.
Because Beyonce tripping.
Definitely. And, I know. I feel like, I mean, I'm not a B fan. These two here are genuine. Yeah. Very much so. I am not, so I may have a different kind of perspective when it comes to her. But trying to be realistic and just keep it surface level, fan or not, I hands down feel like Beyonce is tripping due to the fact that majority of her fans are regular everyday people, like regular everyday
9 to 5.
9 to 5. What do they call us? What range are we in?
We civilians.
Middle class.
Right. Bitch, civilians.
Middle class people. They're the ones buying your albums, records, going to your shows, constantly playing your streaming your music, and you come and say $1,000, and that's probably starting price. Am I
that's
right?
Like disrespectful so, to us.
I'm not
very hands down
the
disrespectful.
U.S.
I don't give a fuck.
But the ones hands for overseas down. Are for sure going for $1,000, and then less is just like I mean at that point.
So you're pretty much shunning the people who got you where you are. I mean, yes, you put in your work, but let's all be clear: you cannot be who you are without fans. Your fans make and create you. So the people who made and create you are assisted you on your journey of making and creating yourself are basically shunned from being able to attend because they can't not fight. And then on top of that, B, have you seen the price of eggs right now? And you talking about $1,000 for a ticket? I'm trying to figure out breakfast for the next 7 days.
In her defense,
she ain't laughing. I ain't never been to a grocery store if I don't buy it.
The price of the ticket actually comes from the promoter. So they get a percentage of that. So she has her, I'm not saying by any means she should go down on her, what she charges to perform because baby, that's your work, baby. Like you did
yes.
that. What makes it higher though, because she is such a grossing artist, is the venue. They know she coming. So now they're going up on their ticket price. They actually make it higher so they can make profit. The promoter, the venue people, and then she gets her cut. So
well, I'm in the wrong field.
Consideration, but like they're really high. So if y'all do get the opportunity to experience that, maybe I'm going to live through you.
Yeah.
But I have my limit that I'm not going to go over for the ticket cost. So if it don't meet my limit, I'm not going. I'll see you in March, Lil Wayne.
Yeah, we got a limit.
I'll see you in April, Lil Wayne. See you in March, Key Glock.
Well, my favorite artist right now is Chris Brown.
Your favorite artist forever has been Chris Brown.
Period. And
I would sell my soul.
I ain't selling my soul to Chris Brown. I ain't going that far. That's why I draw the line. I ain't selling myself for not a soul, nigga. Fuck that. Anywho.
Okay, so let's get into Nini's hot topic.
Ooh.
I'm excited for this because I always hear about it, but I've never tried it.
My hot topic is coming in hot. Oh, moving right along. I want to talk to you guys about sea moss. Okay, so the scientific term for sea moss is called Chondrus crispus. It is known all around the motherfucking world. Okay, very, very popular and grows along the coast of it's in like the warmer climates, like Africa, South Asia, and the Caribbeans. Okay. Sea moss has been around for thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of years, you guys. It was a famine in the land. It was called the Irish potato famine. And during this famine, where food was like little to none, these Irish people, they used seaweed. And they didn't just take the seaweed to, like, they didn't use it as a food only. Like, you know, they were eating it because this is all that they had. It was available. It was a lot of it. So yes, they used it as food, but most importantly, they used it to stay alive. They used it to continue to build on their immune system during like a very, very hard time in their life. They also used it as a way to stay strong. You know, like sea moss, you guys, has so many, many benefits. It's rich in omega-3, zinc, iron, iodine, and if I'm not correct, is it copper? Don't quote me on the copper because that may be aloe vera. But either way, it's great for as an immune booster, big time. It's great for gut health, big time. I use it as a probiotic, and it's really, really great for the brain. So that being said, so this sea moss was made at home. I made this myself.
Is it flavored?
It's not flavored. This is straight sea moss. She just asked you to stop asking so many questions.
I need to know. Okay.
Yeah. It's not flavored.
Sundae be needing a
she don't want a buffer. She
yeah.
Want to jump in
give it to her straight.
And so you can experience it the right way. That's why, you know, something you need to like lay on the palate. That's a lot.
You have to take an actual, this isn't a taste test, you guys.
Okay, so you eat it like applesauce?
Yes. Get a spoon.
So it's applesauce.
It's applesauce.
That's what I'm gonna say.
We're gonna taste it at the, that's too much, sis. Don't knock. We're gonna be picking you up off the floor. Look, tell your man it's applesauce.
Okay, so.
Really applesauce.
Jump into it.
Yes. Okay, Bella. Okay.
It's so chunky. Good. Cinnamon applesauce?
Yep, we can go for cinnamon. Here is to Sundae's first time, Bella's first time, and my 1,000th time.
Girls.
Here, here.
Yeah.
Okay. I have like an industrial taste. It don't really taste like that.
But I
like
Sunday.
It. And it was mixed with something.
Okay.
If it had a flavor though, like it would be good. Like, and you making the face, so.
Yeah, it's still hard for me to. It has a very wild that taste in the back of your throat. It's funky.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's funky.
It's
I don't. I choose to ingest it and not, and not move it around in my mouth because that would just be too much.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I say
it literally like just sat on my tongue for like a minute. No.
It takes me time. It took
me a minute to swallow that shit. It wasn't like apple salt.
It wasn't applesauce.
It wasn't applesauce.
But guess what?
It was healthy. Yes. It tasted like it was.
Yes.
Tastes like crushed up peel.
Do you think that you could incorporate this to your everyday life?
It has to give me something more.
So maybe in a smoothie.
Yeah, if it's
I don't want to taste that. I need like it's a like watermelon taste, yeah. A pineapple taste.
So would you be able to have taste. It? We have a girlfriend of ours. She actually makes and sells CMOS.
I'm going to my sister's earth.
Yes.
Oh, baby, and I'm finna go get some real tomatoes. Something that I can take, okay? Because they say her shit tastes like applesauce.
Hers okay. Definitely, hers is definitely coming like the applesauce flavor. This here, no. Shout out to hers, you guys. Go check her out for the sea moss as well.
Mm-hmm. We're probably gonna do a little segment.
Yeah,
on
when we
shit.
Get some proper moss.
Yeah, and then we'll try hers.
We had chondros because mine was.
That okay. Was, that wasn't sea moss. That was chondros crispy.
Shit. Okay. It was real organic.
It was very musty in the bag.
In the
it was real organic.
This was amazing. We appreciate y'all. If you guys want to give us any notes, tips, anything that you want to see more of in our Through the Fire podcast, we would love to get feedback from you guys. You can leave comments. You can slide into our DMs. All of our social media links will be added below as well. We hope you guys enjoyed our first podcast.
Yes, this is the first one. Episode. First of many.
Keep on the lookout. Love you guys. See you later.
To the fire. To the little girl.
I spit it to the wire, man. There's too much stuff on my heart right now, man. I gladly risk it all right now. It's a life or death situation, man. Y'all don't really understand how I feel right now, man. It's your boy Kanye Chitta. Shatown, what's going on? Yeah, I drink a who's for breakfast?
And then shit for dessert.